guys, welcome back to American Truck Simulator. I am Moose78, and this is my American Truck Sim Let's Play series. Upload this twice a week. If you're new to the channel, first time watching, welcome. Glad to have you along. Hope everyone's doing well today, by the way. Got a lot of stuff to go over today, so let's jump right into it. As you can see, we are in the brand new Peterbilt 389 by SCS Software. Just got released today. Looks pretty good. Couple things need fixed on. I'll probably go over all that stuff in another video, but you can kind of see the sleeper is a little bit messed up. It's got vents on one side and a window on the other. Pretty sure, like 99.9999% sure that it has the windows on both sides. You know, it's either or, it's not, you know, vents and mirror, but that, like I said, we'll get into all that stuff in another video, kind of reviewing the truck and everything like that. If I sound like I'm kind of all over the place, a little bit slap happy, it's because I was up to about 3 o'clock in the morning watching the Chicago Cubs win the World Series. I'm a huge sports fan, I'm a huge Cubs fan, and man, just what an experience to be able to, you know, watch the Cubs win it all and be able to say the Chicago Cubs are your 2016 World Series champion. Pretty amazing. But hey, we're not here to talk about sports, right? We're here to do some trucking. So let's get right into that. We got 35,500 pounds of ice cream going up to Coachella, the Burger King. So that'll be a nice run for us in the 389. Good maiden voyage for it. Interior looks pretty good. We'll kind of take a look around. You got a pretty good view looking out the cab, so that's good. I mean, from what I can tell, the interior seems pretty spot on. There are a couple things missing. You know, still don't have a gear shift, which why they don't put a gear shift in these, I do not know. And there's no like CB or anything like that or radio. But like I said, all that's just kind of little stuff that can be fixed. But let's go ahead and get started and head up to Coachella. Let's take a look at the map real quick because we are down here in Flagstaff. Just going over here to Coachella, so this will be a nice run for us. And just want to give you guys a huge thank you. Started to upload my Grand Theft Auto 5 LS PDFR series this week, and it was met with some pretty positive feedback, some good support, so thank you guys for that. Like I said, I'm going to try to upload that 2-3 times a week. I'm going to try to get another one out tomorrow. Because I do like that mod for GTA 5. It's basically like a whole other game, really is what it is. And it's just a lot of fun. Probably get a news video out here pretty soon. Sounds like we might be getting an update on the map rescale later today, if I read that correctly on the blog post about the 389. I'll be honest, I just kind of skimmed through that real quick because I seen that and I'm like, whoa, the 389? All right. Wasn't expecting that until the map rescale, but yeah, I'll take it. But I thought I read something in there where they were going to say something about the map rescale later today. Could be wrong. Like I said, I'm running on about 3 hours sleep, so I could have saw anything. Really? That's the first time I've done that in a while. I don't see how, because it just, I mean, you look at this, and there's not that much of an incline there, so how the truck rolls back as much as it does there is, you know, kind of crazy to me. But, yeah, I like this combo a lot. You know, back in the Holland days, that's pretty much what I ran was, you know, Peterbilt, you know, 379 with a spread axle reefer. Pretty much ran that exclusively. So it's definitely good to have this ATS. My speed a little bit, because still to this day I forget that it's 25 in Arizona. I'll never hit 65. Using the ISX 550 in this today. I'll get it set up probably maybe later today, hopefully before the next episode, to where it's using one of the modded engines, like one of the Caterpillars. Like to use the one with the straight pipe sound. That one sounds really, really good. Really enjoy that mod. I was real curious to see what the community does with this truck. You know, forever, you know, the Peterbilt 379 and now the 389 has, you know, always been like the most popular truck in the community, at least on the North American side. And you go back to you know, like Truck Mod Shop back in the day, and even Truck Pull screenshots were always flooded with Peterbilts. So it's going to be real interesting to see what the community does with this truck, just in terms of, you know, paint schemes, modifications, things like that. I'm definitely going to be doing some stuff to it. Certainly won't be doing, at least not at this time, or not for the foreseeable future. I know I talked about it a couple episodes back, doing like a Peterbilt pack. But now that this thing's out, I'm just going to tinker with this thing like I have with the W900. And just kind of tweak it to, you know, my taste, my likes, and things like that. I will certainly be putting tons of miles on this old grill for sure. Really feels good to be driving a long hood Peterbilt again. You know, don't get me wrong, I like the 579. Love the 680. Love the W900. But, you know, the Peterbilt has long been one of my favorite truck, or has been my favorite truck. Whether it be cab over, whether it be on the road moose, jackalope. But whether it's been a cab over, whether it's been a conventional, just always been very fond of the Peterbilts. You know, back in the day, my dad drove an old 352 that I absolutely loved that truck. Had a pretty good paint scheme on it. Also drove a 359 back in the day, hauling cattle. That was a pretty cool truck. But always love the looks of them. Just that classic American truck. But going back to that blog post, like I said, kind of what I gathered and kind of what they made it sound like is we could be getting what I took from it. You know, I by no means mean to put words in their mouth, but what I personally took from it was Sounds like the map rescale is just right around the corner. And that is, if that is indeed the case, that is going to be awesome. Jake Brake sounds pretty good on it. Kind of like that. Oh, snappers. Huh. Okay. That got hairy, didn't it? Yeah, I was looking at the mini-map, but I didn't realize it was that type of off-ramp to where there's that steep drop-off, and it's real short. But hopefully we don't have to deal with that for too much longer because the map rescale, like we were just saying, sounds like it's certainly sooner rather than later. And hopefully stuff like that is addressed, and I think it has been, you know, going back to some of the older posts and stuff like that. You know, it sounds like they've done quite a bit to rework the road systems. And at least from what I've experienced so far with American Truck Sim is, you know, the beta lasts maybe a week or so. You know, they iron out all the bugs and then, you know, it's pretty much released, you know, relatively quick after the beta. So that'll be awesome. And I still think, maybe it's just me hoping and wishing, but I still think that we could get some surprises with the map rescale. I thought this would have been one of the things released with the map rescale. Definitely happy that it got released a little bit early. Is it gonna change? Is it gonna change? But I still think, and this is just, you know, my speculation. I don't, you know, it's nothing more than that. But I just got a hunch that we could get some more stuff other than just the map. I, you know, wouldn't be the least bit surprised if we got another truck with it. But like I said, that's probably more so me just kind of hoping and wishing more than anything. So don't take it for any more than exactly just that. I know how the internet is, and you know, to say one thing and then people kind of run to it. Oh my god, Moose said this, he said that. So far so good. I just love looking out that big long Peterbilt hood, and it's just pretty all right. Pretty good. Can't really complain about that at all. But overall, I think this is going to be a pretty popular truck. Guys. And it's just cool seeing all the other Peterbilts out on the highway now. zoom to cruise, and we are good to go. But I know I've talked about it before. I am definitely ready for the map rescale just to get some different stuff. You know, hopefully we get a couple more states. That would be pretty awesome. But it'll be nice just to reset the game, refresh it, and, you know, kind of start all over. And have a much, much better experience. You know, not that I've, you know, me personally, not that I've had a bad experience with ATS so far. You know, clearly I've had a, you know, pretty good experience with it, considering the fact that I'm starting to build a YouTube channel around it. So, I'm just really excited for, you know, what it has in store for us. I think it should be pretty good. But I'm also excited to, you know, get, you know, finally start to get the other content up on the channel that I've been wanting to. You know, the LSPDFR series, I've really enjoyed, you know, working on that, learning how to mod GTA 5, which is a night and day difference from modding American Truck Sim and the SES games. Night and day difference. But starting to figure some stuff out, so that's good. I think once I get a couple more episodes under my belt and get a little bit more comfortable with it, you know, I think the content will start to improve. You know, I'm the type of person that I hate making mistakes. I just hate it. And I think that definitely comes through in my content from time to time. You know, it sounds crazy, but, you know, I'll be thinking about what I want to do for the next episode of American Truck Sim or whatever, and just real laid back, real easy going. Everything sounds good. You know, I got a plan. And then as soon as I hit that record button, it's like, still get a little bit of that stage fright, which is, you know, kind of crazy. But, you know, each episode, each thing that I upload, I'm getting a little bit more comfortable with it, and hopefully that's, you know, starting to come through in my content and everything. What are you doing? Shiitake friggin' mushrooms. Okay, this is new. This is, damn it all, what, where the hell did this come from? Good night, Irene. Man, I kind of wondered why everyone was hitting their brakes. But damn, I didn't know, this must be part of the MHA map, I'm gonna assume. Doesn't look like we have to pay a toll, which is good. Now I'm driving on through. Wow. That was a bit crazy. Not sure why there's a toll road there. Or a toll booth there, because I don't think this is a toll road. Alright. Now that's over. You know, I kind of thought, you know, maybe we were coming up on a town or something like that. You know, so that's why I, you know, come to a complete stop, and, you know, it's kind of why, you know, the accident and everything happened back there, because I had no idea that, you know, everyone was literally coming to a complete stop. Speed limit is 55. Do-do-do-do-do. So we'll back that on down. 58. Should be good there. Or 57. Oh, must not have set it. That is okay. I know one habit I got to break in this game is I tend to look down at the dash quite a bit, you know, down at the gauges and the fuel mileage and all that stuff. Kind of need to break that habit a little bit because I think that's kind of what I was doing back there. Probably could have avoided that a little bit, but it is what it is. You know, like I said just a minute ago, I hate making mistakes, but in the same, I guess I'm not too afraid to make them either. But outside of the LSPDFR content, I still want to finish my Battlefield 1 playthrough. Wouldn't mind starting to get some more of that stuff up maybe tomorrow or maybe over the weekend. And then also want to get some Titanfall content up. I did pick that up last weekend, and I've heard just a lot of good things about that game. Probably do a single player campaign playthrough with that, like I'm trying to do with Battlefield. Because I have played a little bit of that, and man, it just looks so much better than the first Titanfall. And I just keep hearing so many positive things about the multiplayer and just the experience overall. I mean, some of the people that I play Battlefield with have said they enjoy Titanfall 2 more than BF1. So maybe even be on the lookout somewhere down the road for some Titanfall 2 multiplayer footage. Where are we going? Oh, okay, nice. Think I can get in down here. Yeah, here it is. The Burger King. That'd be kind of interesting to see where we have to drop the trailer off at. I imagine now looking at that, we'll probably have to back up next to that other trailer. Where's the marker at? Did I miss it? There we go. Where does you need it? Ah, that shouldn't be too bad. If I can get maneuvered around the parking lot here, okay. Should be fairly reasonable. Think. Huh. That's kind of convenient that that's right there. That little kind of gap in that wall that could come into play here. I know I'm on the curb. That's okay. Nothing to see, kids. Nothing to see. Kind of wish that they would make it to where you can drive around the restaurants. Now this is, you know, this is an SES, this is a MHA map, but what I'm gonna try to do is I'm gonna try to hit that gap back there. Hopefully there's not a collision on it. So I don't think I can back in right there without clipping the building. I've hit enough things already this episode, so. Miss that trailer? Don't think so. Maybe. Just maybe. Oops, not what I want to do. not what I want to do there. Yeah, I don't think I'm going to have enough room to do that. Even if I wanted to. Nope. Dadgummit. That's all right. They're going to straighten it up. Try to hit that little gap back there like I was trying to do originally and take it from there. Yeah, I can't see anything. Yeah, there we go. That, like I said, that is kind of convenient that is right there, because that is going to make this a much, much easier task. Now all I got to do is pull up, straighten it up, back it up, and bada bing, bada boom. I'm even gonna put my sassy pants on and back this thing up in the cab. How about that? Even though I cannot see. Nah, that's not too bad, I guess. Wheel around the other way. There we go. Straighten it up and hope for the best. Dadgummit. Just about had it. There we go. There we go. Much, 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 much better. And there we go. Good work. Why, thank you. All right, guys, well, that is going to wrap it up for another American Truck Sim video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, just give it a like and a share. This helps me out a bunch, helps the channel grow. And if you're new to the channel and are not already subscribed, please take a look around. If you see something you like, consider subscribing. But guys, until the next video, stay safe out there, take care, and we'll be seeing you.